All right, ladies and gentlemen, I want to welcome you back to the People Show, the Vadio Show. And you know I like to name my episodes, and the name of this one is The Game of Love. And I got someone here with me to kind of help me find my way through this Game of Love thing, Brother Edward Fair. How you doing?
I'm wonderful, thank you. I'm just glad to be here.
It's good to have you here, brother.
Thank you, sir.
Now, what I need you to do first is to let people know your credentials, who you are, what you do.
Honestly, I mean, I can go through, I'm a public speaker, I'm a published author on relationships, I'm a relationship coach, but ultimately, I'm a teacher.
Mm-hmm.
I'm a teacher who has been gifted with the ability of simplifying the complex, mm-hmm. and my topic of passion just happens to be relationships.
Gotcha.
And that's who I am.
Okay, well, what made you want to get in this field? What made you want to do the things you do? Because, I mean, it seems like a job, a passion type of deal. You got to have a love for it.
Yeah, I mean, it's interesting that you use the word love. Love is what caused it. And ultimately, mm-hmm. in my marriage, I'll actually be married for 11 years next month.
Nice.
Thank you. When we first started, the first year was great, but year 2 through 4 was, for lack of a better term, hell.
It'd be like that sometimes.
Interestingly enough, I happened to be a technician when I was in the first several years of my marriage, mm-hmm. and as a technician, they teach you to start at the problem and work your way back to where it's good.
Right.
And I said, why not take that approach with my marriage? So I started where everything was bad, which was the marriage, and I worked my way back to the beginning of the marriage. Mm-hmm. And I had an epiphany, and I realized where we went wrong there, mm-hmm. but I couldn't stop there. So I went to when we were in a relationship, and I mm-hmm. realized where we went wrong in our relationship, but I couldn't stop there. So I took that information, then I went back to when we were dating, found out where we went wrong when we were dating, and I couldn't stop there.
Right.
So I actually had to go from when we were apart and when I was dating other people, and mm-hmm. I found universal truths that I was able to practice and put into play to actually fix our marriage.
Right.
And ultimately become friends and fall in love all over again.
Mm-hmm.
And just to go from that dark place as a couple
mm-hmm.
to where we ended up just absolutely loving each other, it was something that I wanted to share with the world.
That's awesome.
Which ultimately produced a book after I realized that the things that we found out that helped our marriage were universal to mm-hmm. anyone, whether it be a race, creed, or whatever. And then I put it in book form to share with the world, and that's where everything took off.
I think that's awesome, first of all, because I don't want to hear nothing from nobody who hasn't been through what I'm going through. You know what I mean?
Yes, sir.
You can't really have a testimony without the test, and you've
That's
obviously
right.
had
That's
the
right.
test. When saying that, counselors, a lot of times, especially these days, people are kind of scared of counselors, man.
Oh, yeah.
Why is that? Because you have some people, I ain't going to no counselor. Nobody tell me about who I am or who I'm dealing with. You know, what is that about?
Well, first of all, people don't want people in their business,
oh,
which
true.
Is very understandable.
Yeah.
So you don't want people in your business, and then you don't want to be judged. Typically, people they feel judged when you're telling somebody. And also, when someone tells you to do something or that you need to get right, typically you reject it because
right.
they told you.
Right.
You're more receptive to mm-hmm. an epiphany in making that cause a change as opposed to someone telling you what you
right,
need to
do. Right, because I'm a grown man. I ain't exactly. trying to get on the grown man.
And
right.
there you go. Pride mm-hmm. itself will make you feel like you know everything.
Right.
Which will prevent you from having a aha moment, if you will, or
right.
an opportunity to learn.
Right, okay. Well, my next thing is, looking at this society that we live in today, mm-hmm. when it comes to love, love has seemed like it's become corny. It's become missing in a lot of ways. Divorce is up, marriage is down, domestic violence is up. It just seems like love is kind of taking a back seat. And even when it comes to the single people out there who aren't getting married, they just want to mingle. They want to have sex, but nobody wants commitment. It just seems like, you know, nobody wants to have that bond or that person to have that walk with. Why do you think that this is happening right now?
Well, honestly, I think because people don't really understand what love is.
Okay.
So if you don't understand something, you just happen to call things that aren't
what
you called it, that's a big problem in itself. Honestly, in my experience and through my consultations, I'm realizing that people mix love and manipulation. And they think that the two are the same thing.
Yeah.
Good example of that is if you really love someone, there's no way that you can be disappointed by their response to your action toward them.
Gotcha.
Why I say that is because if I do something for my wife out of love, it's only to express love.
Right.
How she responds to it can't impact me because I wasn't looking for anything in the first place outside of trying to express
love. Right.
Love.
Right.
But what I mean by manipulation is you get upset or frustrated at her response or lack thereof or his response or lack thereof because you did it
to
looking
get
for
a
something.
Certain response.
There you go.
I got you.
So love is really a one-way street. It just looks like a two-way street when it's done right.
Gotcha.
You feel what I'm saying?
You're a smart guy.
I'm okay.
And humble. That's what's up. Well, I want to get into, because we got to go to a commercial break, I want to get into what you're working on now to kind of take a different approach to counseling. What are you doing? And actually, after the break, we're going to actually show. I know what you're doing, but I wanted to tell the people so after the break, we can take them into it.
Oh, perfect. Well, what I'm doing is, as we already discussed, people don't like to share their business. People have an issue with counselors sometimes, but I've found a solution for that as well. And also, people like to learn on their own.
Yeah.
So I can say that I came up with that,
right,
if you will. So I've created a simulator that allows people to learn through dating, relationship, marriage, and self-counsel themselves so that they can improve their relationships and fail at relationships and learn from them to prevent them from having to do it in real life.
Awesome.
So through that, I've created a board game, which ultimately will be an app, but first I needed to create it in a board game form before I spend thousands of dollars to give it to the people for free.
Yeah,
I need
to
make sure that the people want it first.
A beta testing.
Exactly.
Gotcha.
Most definitely.
Gotcha.
So that's what I've been doing. I've actually taken a year and a half off of public speaking and consultation to do this because this has just been heavy on my heart to do, to make me, for lack of a better term, omnipresent, if you will, to actually tap into the relationships and help those who need the help and want it but don't want to tell people that they need it or want it.
That's an awesome concept, man, and I've seen it. It is ingenious. After the break, you're going to check it out and see a few people playing the game, see how they react to it, all right? This is the Vadio Show. Don't you touch that dial. We'll see you.